Do you have ancestors that are combined to the wrong family? Today, we're going to show you how to break the relationships of your ancestor to the wrong relatives. Now, when I put out a call to ask people, do you have a poorly merged family tree? I was actually given a situation that is a little bit different, which is why I'm making this video. Now, if you want to know how to break a bad merge, two individuals merged together to generate one profile, be sure to check the link in the description below or the video that will pop up at the end of this video so you can watch next. But right now, we're going to talk about badly combined relatives. Now, often you have badly combined relatives for the same reason you have poorly combined people in the FamilySearch family tree: shallow research or same name confusion. So let's hop over to the FamilySearch family tree and show you what the problem is and how I fixed it. Now, thanks to our viewer, June, she sent me in this recommendation of Henry A. Hutchins. And she said, Henry is connected to Benjamin Franklin Hutchins and Sarah Augusta Abbey. What we're gonna do is we're gonna investigate this profile. First of all, there are no sources for Henry A. Hutchins. Well, there's 29 sources for Benjamin. There's 22 for Sarah. There are 6 for Edelbert. And let's go actually look at Edelbert's sources. So he's in the 1880 census. He's in the 1897 getting married, 1900 census. All right, let's go back to the family. Let's go back to Benjamin and look at his sources. So I have these organized by chronologically. 1845, these are main vital records. 1850, there's household. Henry was born in 1867, I believe. So he should show up at 1870 census if Benjamin is still alive. 1860 census. 1880, so there's a big gap. He should still be in the home. So let's look at that real quick. They have a Benjamin, Sarah, and Edelbert, Harry, Valzara, Tina, Francis, and Flora. And if we go back to his children, Edelbert, Harry, and then a number of those children that were listed on that chart. So this Henry seems to have sprouted from nowhere is essentially what June is saying. So in that case, let's also see, how was it ever created in the first place? So we're going to zoom in on the changes from that are happening to the tree. And you're going to notice that it's all in 2012 and the person doing the changing and creating is FamilySearch. Now, in another video, I already talked about why FamilySearch has been changing your family tree. So this is from the initial porting, creation of that database that started the FamilySearch online family tree. And there is no way for FamilySearch to tell you what this came from unless it's attached to an IGI file. But we don't see any sources attached to this. If it came from the IGI collection, then there would be a source. Before we continue, if you would like to support the work that Andy and I do here on Family History Fanatics, there's many ways you can support us. Like this video, leave a comment, share it with your community, or become an FHF Family History Fanatics channel member. All of that information is in the description below. Now, back to the video. So I'm going to actually do these steps on the practice tree that's available for educators on FamilySearch. So June, you're gonna have to go do this live on FamilySearch after this video. So what you do is you scroll down. You need to come into this view of Henry, excuse me, and click on this little pencil in a box. When you click on that, what you're gonna be able to do is you can remove or replace a father. You can remove or replace a mother, or you can remove or replace the child from this relationship. So I'm going to remove this child from the relationship, and you see where the X is. It's going to take him away from both parents. If I had clicked on one of the other links, like this one right here, notice the X moves. So now he would stay with the father, but the mother would be taken off. So if you had a child with the wrong mother, but the right father, you can do it that way. So what we're going to do is we're going to come back down here, remove or replace. So we're going to delete this parent relation. It's recommended that you delete the relationship only when you're confident that the relationship never existed. So I have reviewed the relationship sorts and notices of the individual. Don't just check that box just because you want to. It's an honesty policy. Did you really check that? You're going to make a lot of people upset on the FamilySearch family tree if you break relationships, and they really should have been connected. So make sure that when you check that box, I have reviewed relationship sources notes for this individual, you really have. And then you can choose to either remove or replace the parents. Now, June thinks this person just was invented out of thin air. So we're just going to remove him from the parents. Now, the reason for my change box, reason statement box. I have a lot of posts about writing reason statements over on my blog. Make sure you check the link in the description so that you can access reason statement guidelines and stuff. So I'm going to leave a reason statement and explain why this relationship shouldn't be. After reviewing the sources for Henry's potential parents, a son born in Maine in 1867 does not appear in the census records, vital records, and more. Now, it's actually kind of weak. I should probably put in the parents and maybe put in the personal identification number. So I'm actually going to do that right now. When another researcher comes along later, they're going to know, okay, I looked at the records for these people with this code and this guy never showed up. And that's why I broke the relationship. So I'm going to go to remove parents. I'm going to paste that in and click remove. So now you're going to scroll down. And you're going to see that Henry has no parents. Now I'm going to let you know a little secret. If you want to kind of prevent people from putting him in again and put him in this family, a couple of things you're going to want to do. Come here and delete and say no evidence that Henry was born on that date and in that place. Now you have to at least put a date or a place. This hack used to work where I could just take it all out and then it would be hidden forever and always. So just pick a place where this person wasn't there and click save. And so the next thing you can do is you could actually take off the person's name. You gotta put something there. So why don't you just put the letter H? And then I'm just going to say this person does not seem to have existed. You cannot delete people from the FamilySearch family tree. You can only unlink them and hide them. Now what you're gonna find is that Benjamin no longer has that one son. He doesn't have that Henry. And then if you try to search for Henry, you may find him, a little bit of information about him with 1867 and with the Maine. If you come and try to add him back in, June is gonna have hit this follow button and she's gonna be fully aware that you changed the tree and she's gonna change it back. So make sure that you're adding sources, because if you do actually find that Henry belongs in this family and June didn't know about it, then you need to be attaching them back with documentation. And then that way June and you can have a discussion about the validity of that relationship, because so far in her research, this person didn't exist. Now, I hope that helps you clean up your FamilySearch family tree. Make sure you write those reason statements. Otherwise, people are going to get mad that you're changing their tree. And if you need more tips and tricks on how to use FamilySearch, check out this playlist right here. But as promised, here's a video on how to unmerge poorly combined individuals. That one at all. Okay, well, I can do it better.